The Predator has arrived in theaters. What's up everyone, Carlos here. So the movie is finally out and we all get to see it. Now over the past year, the movie was delayed a few times, either due to the early screening results or the reshoots of the third act, which were changed to night scenes later on. Now these changes and delays did cause some fans to be worried over the finished product of The Predator. But was it worth the wait? Well, that depends on what you were expecting. The story focuses on a fugitive predator being chased by another predator. It's not mentioned until later in the film, but the fugitive is a traitor to the predator race. He stole some technology and was going to give it to the humans. This was something to fight against any future predators coming to Earth. So right there, the movie starts out differently. It's not just a hunt, it's already bringing up new ideas. One predator becomes a rogue, and then another one is sent in to stop him. Now, there were some scenes where both predators showed off their impressive agility, so they did not appear as sluggish, lumbering hunters, so it was a nice way to keep them interesting. Now, the ultimate predator turned out to be a genetically enhanced hybrid. Its DNA consisted of the strongest prey found on different worlds. It was able to use heat vision without a biomask, turn invisible without any gear, and also had other abilities. This new predator would also use a different vision mode, which seemed to act as a long-range scanner. Based off the footage I saw in the movie, it scans an area and a target is located or displayed in a different way. I'm not sure, but I think this was like an X-ray scanner or maybe something else. The properties of its skin were also changed. Some areas on its body would form a hardened, thick armor just on its skin, and this could withstand some firearms. As for the weapons it used, it mostly used the single wrist blade and the wrist-mounted plasma launcher. I really liked what they did with the ultimate predator, but then they introduced predator dogs. Most of them had a very short scene in the movie. Then for some reason, one of the dogs befriends the humans, and that's one thing that I did not really agree with. It just felt so out of place. I also felt like the story was being explained too quickly and with important details being left out. I think it could have been stretched out a bit longer. I really wanted at least one of the predators to survive, but in typical fashion, the predators always die. I was hoping to see at least one of them stay alive so they could leave it open for a sequel in some way. The whole idea around DNA hybridization may have turned off some of the fans early on, but I think it was okay for the story. But it also contradicts the standard predator lore. The Yautja species don't want to tamper with their bodies in any way, especially their bloodline. They want to stay pure and see themselves as the dominant species already. So when they made the ultimate predator, it was in a way going against their code. But since they were tracking down a traitor, I guess this hybrid or this ultimate predator was one exception to this rule. In the comic books, there was a story of an enforcer predator who tracked down a bad blood predator, and the enforcer was not successful in his mission and died. So I guess this ultimate predator was a guarantee the fugitive would be eliminated. The idea of taking the DNA from the spinal column of their victims did make sense for the story, so I felt it was a great addition to the predator mythology, at least for the ultimate predator. I did like the cast of soldiers within the Loonies group, but I think there was way too much humor here. There was more humor in this movie than the other movies, and I think it was a bit too much. And actually, I did not find the jokes that funny. I just smiled, and that's it, I was over it. I was anticipating the action scenes, only to be overwhelmed with way too many jokes. The whole cast worked well together, so in the end, I kind of liked them all and I had no other issues with them. The actor who played the son of Peter Keyes had a very short role in the movie, but I think they could have brought up more details about the previous encounters from the other movies, but very little was mentioned about that. I just think it would have been nice to bring up those past events and say more than this: the Predators came to Earth in 1987, and then again in 1997, and their visits are becoming more frequent. I would have liked to see them bring up these details that occurred back then in the first two movies, and there really was nothing mentioned about Dutch, something I was hoping to finally give us answers about his whereabouts. Some scenes from the trailer were not in the film, so I guess they are now deleted scenes. This also happened in Alien Covenant. Now, one issue I have with deleted scenes is they sometimes help explain the story, but for some reason they're removed just to be included as deleted scenes on the Blu-ray or DVD versions, which doesn't really make sense because if these deleted scenes explain the story much better, then why not keep it intact? Now, since the beginning, I never really doubted the movie like the other fans did. I stayed positive that the movie would be all right. But judging by the leaked script I read a long time ago, I had a feeling that some ideas were not going to be accepted by the fans. The cast from this movie was compared to the original, and there is a big difference, but to be honest, I actually liked them all. Jason Tremblay's character fit into the story, and his acting was actually really good. And as for the actor Boyd Holbrook, who played the character Quinn McKenna, he was actually very likable. He was not trying to mimic the other characters in previous Predator movies, so he came off as his own character with his own story and unique personality. Now, the pace of the movie seemed a bit rushed in some areas. The movie seemed to rush through point A just to reach point B a bit quickly, and in the end, I just wanted more of the story, but it went by too fast. Now, let's talk about the ending of the movie. The fugitive Predator was actually going to help the human race by giving them stolen technology to fight against the Predators, and this thing was a full body armor suit that was made of some type of nanotechnology. It covered the host in full Predator gear and came with these massive double cannons. Something about this scene just felt a bit out of place. It finished off by Quinn saying, "That's my new suit." So, this could be a nod towards the story of human predators, something that was mentioned a few times in the comic books. Now, I went to the theaters expecting a decent Predator movie, and that's really what I got. I had a feeling it was just going to be average or slightly above that mark. Sure, some things could make it better, but I still enjoy the film for what it is. The soundtrack also had some nods to the original soundtrack in the first movie, but this was not overused, so it was a nice touch. But at the same time, I can understand why some fans may be disappointed with this movie. They did not get the best Predator movie that they expected. It did introduce new ideas, but the quick pace of the movie and the amount of humor was too much for me. I wanted more backstory to the Predators, more information about their homeworld, rituals, hunts, just something different other than coming to Earth and hunting, and then, of course, the Predators always die. So, with that being said, I would give the Predator a rating of 6 out of 10. Not the worst Predator movie, but certainly not the best. But it was just all right, so it was average. But I also want to know what you thought about the movie. What did you like and dislike about it? Tell me in the comment section. And that wraps up this video. My name is Carlos, or Acid Glow, and I'll see you in the next hunt.